The Kievan Rus was a medieval Slavic people who inhabited the region that today encompasses Ukraine, Belarus, and parts of Russia. The term Kievan Rus refers to the period when the city of Kiev was the capital and political center of Russian civilization. The Kievan Rus is believed to have emerged because of a merger of different ethnic groups and tribes from the Eastern European region, mainly during the 8th and early 9th centuries. The main historical source on the formation of the Kievan Rus is the Primary Chronicle, supposedly written in the 12th century by Nestor, a monk of the Kiev Monastery. This is the oldest and most important source of ancient Russian history. According to the Primary Chronicle, the three brothers Rurik founded the Kievan Rus, Cineas and Truvor, originally leaders of the Varangian warriors, basically Vikings who came from Scandinavia and moved to Eastern Europe, where they occupied new lands. This narrative implies that the Scandinavian Varangians played a significant role in the foundation of the ruling dynasty in Kiev. Rurik is considered the most important leader and was the founder of the Rurikid dynasty that ruled the Kievan Rus. Besides the influence of the Scandinavian Varangians, the Kievan Rus were also formed by East Slavic tribes inhabiting the region, such as the Polish Slavs and the Drevlians. The interaction between the Scandinavians and the Slavic tribes formed the Russian-Ukrainian society known as the Kievan Rus. The Kievan Rus established trade and political relations with the Byzantine Empire and other peoples of Eastern Europe. The relationship between the Kievan Rus and the Byzantine Empire was particularly important during the medieval period. This bond had significant impacts on the politics, culture, trade, and religion of both civilizations. The relationship with the Byzantine Empire began to develop in the early 10th century. Through trade, the Kievan Rus had access to products from the Byzantine Empire, such as spices, textiles, jewelry, and other valuable goods. In return, the Kievan Rus exported furs, honey, wax, or slaves. The growing trade relationship between the two empires was bolstered by political and matrimonial alliances. Marriages between members of the Byzantine and Kievan Rus royal families made it possible to seal agreements and ensure peace between the empires. Before the arrival of Byzantine Orthodox Christianity, the Slavic peoples of the region had their own religious beliefs and practices, which were known as Slavic paganism, a polytheistic religion. In other words, followers believed in multiple gods and goddesses who personified several natural forces and aspects of human life. These gods and goddesses were worshipped in rituals, festivals, and sacrifices at sacred grounds, such as mountains, rivers, or woods. Slavic paganism was deeply rooted in people's traditions and everyday life, influencing agriculture, harvests, marriages, or births. Vladimir I of Kiev, also known as Vladimir the Great, was one of the most prominent rulers of Kievan Rus. He led as Grand Prince of Kiev from approximately 980 to 1015, being one of the most influential princes of the Rurikid dynasty. During his regency, Vladimir expanded the territory of Kievan Rus, conquering new lands and neighboring principalities. The expansionist policy was carried out through successful military campaigns against neighboring tribes, such as the Pechenegs, Volga Bulgarians, and Kazakhs, consolidating his power and influence in the region. Vladimir was known as a pagan and polytheistic ruler, obeying Slavic paganism, the predominant religion in Kievan Rus at the time. But he sought a religion that would unify the kingdom and strengthen international relations. Vladimir sent emissaries to study the major religions of the time, including Islam, Judaism, and Byzantine Orthodox Christianity. In the end, the emissaries returned with positive reports on Byzantine Orthodox Christianity, describing the magnificence of the religious ceremonies in Constantinople and the beauty of the churches and mosaics. According to the Primary Chronicle, Vladimir decided to convert to Byzantine Orthodox Christianity in 988, after marrying the Byzantine princess Anna, sister of the Byzantine Emperor Basil II. The conversion of Vladimir I was a milestone in the Christianization of Kievan Rus. After the conversion to Christianity, the Kievan Rus welcomed missionaries and clerics from the Byzantine Empire to help establish the Orthodox Church in their lands. Ecclesiastical and cultural relations grew stronger, and the Byzantine Empire had a major influence on the architecture, art, and liturgy of the Russian Orthodox Church. Yaroslav I, also known as Yaroslav the Wise, was one of the most important rulers of Kievan Rus. He was born around 978 and ruled as Grand Prince of Kiev from 1019 to 1054. Yaroslav was the son of Vladimir the Great, the ruler who introduced Orthodox Christianity to Kievan Rus. During his reign, Yaroslav was a wise and skillful leader who tried to strengthen and expand the rule of Kievan Rus. Yaroslav is known for having codified the laws of Kievan Rus in the document Ruskaya Pravda, an important milestone in Russia's legal history. This code of laws was based on Christian principles and Slavic customs, helping to establish a more organized legal structure in the principality. Yaroslav fostered culture and education, founding schools and educational institutions, and promoting the translation of religious and literary texts from Greek and Latin into Slavonic. Yaroslav was responsible for several significant architectural works in Kiev. He built and renovated churches and monasteries, including St. Sophia Cathedral, an iconic landmark of the Kievan Rus, and today, a major tourist attraction in Kiev. The history of the Kievan Rus was marked by infighting between different branches of the ruling dynasty and other regional leaders. Rivalry between the princes, known as knyats, led to frequent armed conflicts and civil wars as different princes sought to consolidate their hold on territories and resources. The Kievan Rus often fought with neighboring tribes, such as the Pechenegs, Polovtsians, and other nomadic peoples inhabiting the Eurasian steppes. These conflicts were often motivated by territorial issues, control of trade routes, and revenge against attacks on Kievan villages. The resistance of the Kievan Rus against the Mongols was one of the most dramatic chapters in medieval Russian history. After the devastating Mongol raid in 1240, known as the Golden Horde invasion, the Mongols subjugated the Kievan Rus. The subsequent period became known as the Mongol-Tartar domination. The Russian principalities fiercely resisted the Mongol invasion, but the Mongols' superior military technology and war tactics were overwhelming. Cities were sacked, the population massacred, and many government structures and churches destroyed. In 1240, the city of Kiev was conquered and razed to the ground by the Mongols. After the invasion, the principalities of Kievan Rus were forced to obey Mongol authority and pay tributes to the Golden Horde. Most of the local princes kept their governments and domains, but now under Mongol suzerainty, the Russian princes became vassals of the Golden Horde leaders and were forced to supply soldiers to the Mongol army whenever needed. Over time, revolts and attempts at resistance against Mongol rule arose. Some cities and principalities tried to mutiny and break the submission, but the Mongol reaction was brutal and relentless. One of the most famous resistance attempts was led by Dmitry Donskoy, the Prince of Moscow. In 1380, he led a Russian army against the Golden Horde in the famous Battle of Kulikovo. Although a strategic victory for the Russians, the engagement did not allow complete liberation from Mongol rule, but proved that the Mongols were not invincible. Russian resistance against the Mongols was a long and gradual process. In the late 14th and early 15th centuries, the Golden Horde began to weaken and fragment internally. This allowed some Russian principalities to break free from Mongol rule and become independent again. In 1480, the Golden Horde attempted to renew the levying of tribute from the Russian principalities. However, Grand Prince Ivan III of Moscow, also known as Ivan the Great, refused to pay, signaling Moscow's complete independence from the Golden Horde. The resistance of the Kievan Rus against the Mongols was a turbulent and challenging period in their history, but it helped pave the way for the emergence of the unified Russian state under Moscow's leadership. These internal and external wars and conflicts played a vital role in the decline of Kievan Rus and regional political fragmentation. After the Mongol invasion, the territories of former Kievan Rus were divided into several independent principalities, each ruled by local princes. This was the end of Kievan Rus as a unified entity. The independent principalities that emerged from this fragmentation were the forerunners of the future states of Russia, Belarus, and Ukraine, each with unique cultural heritage and identity. The lofty history of the Kievan Rus and the traces of this glorious era continue to fascinate historians and tourists today, who explore the mysteries and wonders of this brilliant period in Eastern European history. The Kievan Rus is remembered as a resilient and influential civilization, whose achievements and challenges set the path for the modern world.